Yes.
Saturday, the same man, they back in the Lord's house, and other than, they met, we thank God for privilege, and they met of just being here. Amen. Boy, I tell you how I praise his holy and precious name. Amen. Tonight for all of his goodness and mercy and kindness. Amen. We're glad, thank God for each and every one that has come back out to be with us tonight. You pray tonight that God will have his way. Amen. In everything that is said and done. Amen. If we can leave out here, say, most men good. Amen. To be in the house of the Lord. Amen. It's good when he shows up.
Amen.
Amen. If he don't show up, I just say, stay in the house. Amen. Amen. But I'm glad, thank God, that he comes by and visits us. Amen. Helps us along life's journey. If you got your Bibles and you want to read with us tonight, we're going to be over in the book of Exodus. Amen. In chapter number 14. Amen. Reading a little bit of scripture tonight, starting down in verse number 19. And amen. Going through verse number 22. And I just want you to listen to the reading of God's Word. And then the Lord give us a little thought, amen, on this, amen. And, but before we get down in verse number 19, I want to read, starting in verse number 19, amen. Then we'll try to go where the Lord wants us to go, amen. Amen. Just trying to follow his lead, amen, because if I get in the lead, we're in trouble tonight, amen, amen. But over in the book of Exodus, in chapter 14, amen, down in verse number 19, and it said, and the angel of God, which went before the camp of Israel, removed and went behind them, and the pillar of the cloud went from before their faces, and stood behind them. And it came between the camp of the Egyptians and the camp of Israel. And it was a cloud and darkness to them, but it gave light by night to these, so that the one come not near the other all the night. And Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord caused the sea to go back by a strong east wind all that night, and made the sea dry land, and the waters were divided. And the children of Israel went into the midst of the sea upon the dry ground, and the waters were a wall unto them on the right hand and on their left. Amen. Let us pray. Father, dear Lord, it's again, God, we come to you tonight with humble hearts, thanking you, Lord, for this day. Thanking you, God, for another opportunity, Lord, of being back in your house one more time. And God, we ask you tonight, Lord, as we come to you, Father, so as we know how, that, Lord, for the next few minutes, God, that you would use us. Lord, use these lips of clay, and God, fill them, Lord, with the words, God, that you would have us to say tonight. Father, we pray tonight, Lord, if we've done or said anything, Lord, that would hinder this in any way, we pray, Father, that thou would forgive us. Lord, move us up close to the cross, and God, to make preaching easy. Father, we pray tonight, Lord, that you touch the hearts of men and women, Lord, that are here tonight, God. And Father, that, Lord, that you might fill it with a peace and a joy, Lord, that comes down from above. And God, how we praise you, Lord, for everything that you've done. And God, we thank you tonight, Lord, for that you're getting ready to do. And Father, Lord, just have your way, God, in everything, Lord, that is said and done. And God, whatever's accomplished tonight, Lord, will not fail, Father, to bow our head and, Lord, to give you the praise and the honor and the glory, Father, for we ask it all in Jesus' holy and precious name we do pray. And amen and amen. If you back up in this chapter 14, and if you back up, amen, to verse number 13, amen, we want to read just a little part of this and take our thought tonight. And Moses said unto the people, amen, fear ye not. Amen. Now listen to what he said. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not, and stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord. Amen. And if we had a thought tonight that I'd like to use just for a little while, amen, if the Lord might permit me to, I'd like to use a thought just for a little while on standing in faith. Amen. And boy, I'm telling you tonight, faith is a great big thing. Amen. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, but the evidence of things not seen. Amen. So we see here tonight, amen, I want to show you some things about the Lord. Amen. And about what God does for us. Amen. Tonight now, Moses, you got to understand, whenever he led the children of Israel come up and they come against the Red Sea. Amen. They could hear the armies coming from behind them. Amen. And there was no place literally for them to go. Amen. And don't you feel like it sometimes? Amen. Don't you feel like that the devil comes against you with everything that he's got, and they ain't a place in the world that you can go? Amen. And the only thing that you can do is stand still. Amen. And brother, I'm telling you now, Moses, God had worked with Moses. Amen. You remember upon the mountain at the burning bush. Amen. And the many miracles that he had worked through Moses in order to convince Pharaoh to let the children of Israel go. We find a few chapters back, amen, that the blood had been already been applied to the door. Amen. And when the death angel come, the Bible said that whenever he seen the blood, that the angel would pass over them. Now, here they are in the Red Sea. Amen. You would think, amen, that the children of Israel, by the time they got to this point, had learned a little bit. Amen. But undoubtedly, amen, they hadn't learned very much. Amen. Because they fell right back into the same old things. Amen. They begin to gripe. They begin to complain. They begin to, I wonder why God brought us out here, amen, to let the army come up and to kill us. Amen. And all sorts of nonsense. Amen. And then we find the leader, Moses, amen. He was standing there just as calm as he could be, amen. But I tell you tonight, amen, whenever we stand in faith and we realize that God is who that he says he is, amen, we can stand in the midst of a battle knowing that God is on our side and victory will prevail in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus. Jesus Christ. I'm glad tonight. I thank God even when the battles of this life have got you bent below. I just stand tall in the faith, for God is there tonight. Amen. We find some things. Amen. We find one thing. God had everything in control. These people didn't realize it. Amen. But God was done already on the scene. Amen. He come. Amen. Ain't you? I'm glad tonight that God stands between us and the enemy. Amen. You know what we'd be if a devil could ever lay his hands on us? Amen. Tonight he told Peter, boy, the Lord told Peter, he said, I'll shift you like wheat. Amen. Boy, I tell you, I'm glad tonight there is a presence and it's standing between me and the evil one. Amen. I'm glad tonight, thank God. And brother, there's only a certain amount of things that the devil can do. And one thing that he cannot do, he can't cross that bloodline. Amen. I'm glad tonight. I thank God, even though we might fight battles, even though we might have trials, and even though it seems sometimes our back is against the wall, God is always there, and he's in between us and the evil one. If he wasn't, the devil would kill every one of us all. But there's a power that he's shining in between us and the evilness of this old world. Amen. God, it said here in verse number 19, and the angel of God, which went before the camp of Israel, amen, removed and went behind them. Amen. This evening he was in front of them. Amen. Tonight he was protecting them as they was on their journey. When the enemy
enemy started to come up behind them. Amen. The angel of the Lord come around in behind them. Amen. To protect them. And he put a cloud over them. Amen. Tonight to where the Israelites, and brother, this evening the Egyptians, they could not move. Amen. And because there was darkness surrounded all over them. But the children of Israel, amen, they was a light that was shining. Amen. I'm glad tonight I live in a dark world. Amen. But there is a light that is shining in our life that will lead us and guide us in the ways that we need to go. And when we get discouraged, I'm sure we do. And when we get tired, you better believe it. Are there times we feel like I'm giving up? Yes. Are there times that you think about what's the use? And they sure are. Having been about the time you get real low, that fire begins to burn again in the bones. Amen. And that is the Holy Spirit of God. Amen.
Amen.
See, the children of Israel had got theirself into a place to where they couldn't do anything. How many times do we get ourselves in a place, amen, where we can't do anything? Amen, there's things going on all around us, amen, that we don't have a bit of control of, amen, than a man in the moon. Amen, there's nothing we can do. There's nothing we can say. Amen, tonight, and boy, I'm telling you, sometimes, amen, we got to be like the children of Israel. Well, not so much like the children of Israel, but we got to be like Moses. Amen, tonight, and just stand still, amen, and just wait upon God. Amen, times in my life, amen, that I've had things to happen in my life. Amen. And I've looked up to heaven and I've said, God, I don't understand what you're doing. Amen. But Lord, I know you know more about it than what I do. And God, I'm just trusting in you. Amen. And brother, just stand there. Amen. Just stand still and wait upon the mighty hand of God to move. Amen. God was getting ready to move. Amen. I've seen a lot of people go through a lot of things. Amen. Lord, they'll stand and they'll wait on God. I might tell you tonight, amen, it's easy to preach to stand and wait on God. And the new one, it's a whole different color, amen. It's a whole different animal, amen, when you're standing and waiting on God to show up. We like God to hurry up. And boy, I tell you, we live in a time and when we want something, we want it like yesterday. Amen, the children of Israel, they wanted out of this mess. I can hear the enemy coming. Amen. I don't know about you, but sometimes in this journey, I can hear the enemy in behind me. I'm getting closer and closer. But boy, I tell you what, I'm glad that God is able, thank God, to put an angel on guard in the rear view mirror. Amen. To keep the enemy at bay. Listen tonight. And more the children of Israel, they was getting ready to see a great miracle if they just wait upon God. Amen.
Amen.
God always knows what he's doing. Mm-hmm. Amen. Sometimes, the biggest part of the time, amen, we don't know what we're doing.
Amen.
Amen. You want to be honest about it? Amen. The biggest part of the people, they fly by the seat of their pants. Amen. Amen. They do the best they can. Amen. Make mistakes along the way. Amen. And boy, after they get over it, guess what? They'll turn right around and do the same old mistake all over again.
Yeah.
Amen. And wonder why it turns out with the same consequences. Amen. Listen tonight. I finally learned. Amen. After about 65 years, if you keep drawing water from a dirty well, you're always going to be getting dirty water. Amen. Amen. I learned to change wells. Amen. And get into the well that springs up into us life everlasting and that eternal life. Amen. There they was. complaining to Moses, amen. And boy, I'm telling you what, I've been in churches before, amen. And boy, pastor churches, amen. I told my wife one time, we was in this little old church, and I said, you know what? I said, I had the notion to go out, amen, buy about 50 baby bottles, about 50 pacifiers, and as they come in the church door, hand them a baby bottle and a pacifier, and then when they go out, pat them on the back and burp them, and tell them to have a good week. Listen tonight, I mean, that's one of the children of Israel I was putting Moses through, and Moses said, hey, he said, if you'll just stand still, if you'll just be quiet, and just stand still, and pray, amen, God is going to take care of this thing, amen. Might I tell you, tonight you'll never walk in faith until you learn to stand in faith. Amen. You got to learn how to stand in faith, first of all. Amen. You got to learn that God is in control of this thing. Amen. The Lord knows what He's doing. Amen. God and Moses told him, He said, just stand still. Amen. Just stand still. You're getting ready to see something that is amazing. Amen. God is getting ready to show up. Amen. We read about apostles in the New Testament. Amen. That they just had to stand still and they wait upon God. Amen. Sometimes God will put us in situations, amen, where we ain't got no other choice, amen, but just to stand and wait, amen, because there's nothing that we can do. Amen. You take whenever Paul and Silas, amen, was bound up in jail, they couldn't have got out if they'd have wanted to. Amen. God put them there. Amen. Tonight, and you know what they had to do? They had to wait upon God. Amen. There wasn't no other place to go. I mean, they had block walls all around them and a big old hard door with a big old padlock on it. Amen. This evening, and they had chains around their ankles. Amen. Tonight, they couldn't go anywhere. And you know what old Paul said? Well, he said, we'll just make the best of the situation. Amen. And he said, what we'll do is we'll just start singing praises unto the Lord. And might I tell you tonight, when the devil's got your back against the wall, and there ain't no place that you can go, amen, the best thing you can do is just begin to praise His holy name, and to thank Him for what He's getting ready to do in your life, and because He has a miracle coming your way tonight. Amen. So we see that God was before them. He wasn't only before them, but He was behind them. Amen. And God was getting ready to provide a way of escape. Amen. Boy, I'm telling you, when I got to reading this and studying it a little while ago, amen, tonight there's some times, amen, that we come to red seas in our life. Amen. There's some times that we come, amen, to the point to where we don't think we can go any further. Amen. Tonight, boy, I'm telling you, we come to a point sometime, amen, tonight that we just wonder what in the world are we supposed to do. Amen. Tonight, and God is saying, amen, when you get to that point in your life, just stand still. Amen. Just wait and just look around you. Amen. And look at everything that God has done. Amen. And the way that God has blessed them. If they had taken a few minutes of time, amen, and remembered where they come from and where they was at, that was enough to be a blessing. Amen. Right. And there's a lot of times when the old devil, amen, he'll get to fighting me. Amen. You know what I remember a lot of time? I remember what I was like when I was 20 years old. I remember where I was at when I was 21. I remember where I was at in the early part of my age whenever I was 22. And boy, I tell you what I realized, amen, what God done in my life at that point, amen, tonight. And only God could do that, amen. And brother, God is the same God today as He was then, amen. And brother, I'm telling you tonight, God and the children of Israel couldn't go to God, amen, but boy, God could sure come to that. Ain't you glad tonight? Amen. Boy, we can't get to heaven, but heaven can sure get to us. And He come to us in a mighty form called Jesus Christ. picture of. He's a picture of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He was an intercessor between the children of Israel and God. And Jesus is that intercessor today for you and me. Amen. Tonight, and I'm glad He is a God and He's capable of delivering us anytime we need be delivered. Amen. In any kind of situation that we're in, God is able to let us do the impossible through Jesus. Amen.
Thank you,
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, Moses began to pray, standing in faith. Amen. Sometimes all you can do is stand. Sometimes when you pray, all you can pray. Amen. And it don't seem like no answers come. Amen. Then you just stand. Amen. Just stand and wait on God to show up. I believe Moses might have looked up to the Lord. Amen. Using my imagination for a little bit. I believe Moses might have looked up to God. And I believe he might have said, Lord, I got myself in a mess. And I need a little bit of help. Amen. Tonight, and boy, I'm telling you what, when we go to God like that, amen, just be honest before God and say, God, I got myself in a mess. And Lord, I need a little bit of help. Amen. God already knows the mess you're in. Amen. Tonight, the enemy would have captured them a long time ago if God hadn't come in between them and the enemy. Amen. Might I tell you tonight, the devil, if you're in here tonight and you're saved by the blood of Jesus Christ, the devil's hot on your heels. Amen. And the only thing tonight that is keeping the devil from catching you and destroying you, amen, is we got that great force in between us and the enemy. Amen. And his name is Jesus Christ. Amen. I believe Psalmist put it there. He said, I'll send angels to encamp around about you. Amen. That I might protect you. Ain't you glad you're protected tonight? Amen. Tonight, some people like a 357. Amen. Some people like a sawed-off shotgun. Amen. Some people like a high-powered rifle. I like Jesus. Amen. 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 Well, I'll tell you what. He can save me, and He can protect me, and I'll never wind up in a court of law for self-defense. Amen. Amen. And because God is able to protect us, amen, tonight when we need a protection the most. I believe after Moses had talked to God, I believe he told the children of Israel, now watch what God is getting ready to do for you one more time. Amen.
Amen.
Moses prayed. And he took that rod and put it out over the Red Sea. Boy, I'm telling you, when he done that, Bible said that there was a mighty wind. Amen. Now, the good thing about this is that mighty wind didn't come just from anywhere. You know where it come from? Come out of the east. Amen. You remember that east gate? Amen. Tonight, boy, there are a lot of good things happening in the east. Amen. Amen. Tonight, God sent that strong wind out of the east. Amen. Amen. Boy, we've had hurricanes that come and pass through all our coastal lines. Amen. And I have never yet seen an ocean, amen, with the water stand up as the walls, amen, and the ocean floor dry out. Amen, tonight, and boy, I'm telling you what, I believe this wind, I believe it was a mighty wind. I believe the children of Israel, they stood there, and boy, they was a wonder what in the world was going on, amen, tonight. Amen. And they, sometimes God goes to work in our life, amen, and boy, He'll begin to make a noise, amen, and we'll begin to wonder what in the world's going on, amen. And then all at once, God showed up. I believe the Bible said that there was one wall of the water, boy, just stood right straight up. Amen. And then, boy, that wind took the other side of that wall and just stood it right straight up. Amen. I believe the children of Israel were standing there, her eyes bigger than golf balls. Amen. About ready to pop out of their head about what in the world is going on. Hey, God just showed up. Amen. God is in the house. He's getting ready to make a way when there ain't nobody else can. Amen. Tonight, boy, the Red Sea had never been parted. Have you listened to me tonight? Bible says tonight, amen. And he said he'd become, and he'd come between the camp of the Egyptians and the camp of Israel. And it was cloudy and darkness to them, but he gave light by night to these. And that by that, the one came near to the other of the night. He kept them apart. Amen. Tonight, boy, I tell you, you can go out of here tonight thanking God. Amen. That God puts distance between you and the devil. Amen. Because I guarantee you, if you'd ever take the devil on, you'd lose. Amen. Tonight. Amen. Because the devil is more powerful than you are tonight. Standing in faith. Amen. Amen. Tonight we find other ones in the scripture. Amen. That stood in the faith. Amen. We find the Hebrew children. Amen. Tonight, as that old king said, you will bow. Amen. And worship my God. Amen. And they told him, said, no, we won't. Amen. You can ring that bell. You can chime that chime all you want to. Amen. These knees are not going to the ground. And we're not going to bow. Amen. Tonight. And boy, I'm telling you, one of them told the king, said, whether God will or not, I don't know, but I know that he's able. Amen. Listen tonight, brother, I'm telling you tonight, and they went into the old fiery furnace. Amen. Listen, I like that song Sister Debbie sang. Amen. He's still in the fire. Amen. I'm glad tonight, whenever we go through the fiery trials of this old life, we can come out with not even a smell of smoke upon us. Thanks be to God. Amen. I'm glad when we're in trouble, he's there. When we're in the enemy's camp, he's there. And when we're surrounded by evil forces, he is the one. I'm walking in the midst. I'm saying I'm God and there's no other.
Amen.
He made a way for the children of Israel.
Yes, he did.
To escape. He'll make a way for you to escape.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Standing in the faith. Amen. Sometimes you just gotta stand and wait on God. Amen. Because see, God, we're on a journey. We're like the children of Israel. Amen. We're in a wilderness in this land. Amen. This land that we live in. Amen. This is not my home. Amen. This is just a place where I'm packing up, getting ready to go, getting ready to move in. We're like the children of Israel. Amen. We're in a land of wilderness. Amen. And brother, I'm telling you, the enemy is all around us. Amen. But we see in our life, and tonight, you know what Jesus does? Whenever he saves us, amen, he don't stand you up. Amen, said, do the best you can and pat you on your butt and send you away. Amen, tonight, boy, the Holy Spirit of God. Amen, tonight, the Bible said that we are led by the Holy Spirit of God. Now, you get this. If we're led by something, amen, that thing that is leading us has got to be before us. Amen. And so the Holy Spirit of God goes before us. Amen. That it might lead us. Amen. You know what the shepherd would do for the sheep? He'd take that staff. Amen. And he'd walk that little old hillside and he'd knock away all the stones that was loose. Amen. That the lambs might not be able and that they might not stumble. I'm glad tonight that God is going before us tonight, clearing the path that me and you might be able to walk on. Brother, if he did it, we'd break our blooming neck. Amen. And a lot of them's too short to tie back. So you better thank God tonight. And he goes before you preparing a way that you might be able to walk in the righteousness of the Almighty God.
Amen.
Standing in faith. Sometimes we just got to stand still. Sometimes we just got to wait upon God. When the Lord put this TV program on our heart, I mean, man, he really burdened me down with this thing. And I prayed and I prayed and I prayed. And me and Eve has always had a thing, amen, that about if we're going to go step out on a limb and we're going to go get something, amen, then we'll sit down and we'll talk about it. Amen, and if both of us don't agree on it, Amen. I just leave it alone. And she just leaves it alone. Amen. Tonight, but if we're in agreement, amen, we'll go ahead with it. Amen. Tonight, and I told her, I said, God has really burdened me down about this TV thing. Amen. Tonight, and boy, I prayed and waited. Amen. She was a praying. Amen, and waiting. Amen, and boy, I'll tell you what, there were some days went by, amen, tonight, and God said, you need to do what I'm telling you to do. Amen, so I looked at her, I said, I feel led by God to go ahead and do this thing. Amen, you know what she told me? She said, if you feel led by God to go ahead and do it, you go ahead and do it, and I'm behind you 100%. Amen, and listen tonight, that's the way, but we need to wait upon God. Amen, we need to get the approval. Amen. From the master planner. Amen. That's what he wants us to do. Listen tonight, brother. I'm telling you, I'm glad tonight he wasn't only put man between them and the enemy. I'm glad, thank God, that he was protecting them on both sides. But I'm glad tonight that he was the one going before them. He's the one that parted the waters. Amen. He was the one that hit the sandy beach first. Spend it already and dried up. Listen tonight. God always has your best interest at heart if you are a child of God.
Amen.
But there's sometimes you just gotta wait. I got a call here a little while ago. It just kept going on and on. And I finally told him, I said, listen, I said, let me tell you something. I said, sin will keep you out of the house of God. Yeah. Amen. Tonight, and brother, if there's sin in your life, you're going to find every excuse of why you don't need to be there. And I said, if you're saved by the blood of Jesus, you'll bend over backwards to be in God's house. Amen, tonight. And I said, the trouble is in this conversation is that a lot of people are not who they say they are. Amen, tonight. And boy, I'm telling you what, once that words come out of my mouth, all at once that conversation was real short and I got to go by it. Amen, listen tonight. But it's the truth, amen. Yeah. If we love the Lord tonight, God said, if you love me, keep my commandments, amen. If you love me, walk with me. If you love me, pick up the cross and follow me. I mean, the cross is heavy. But Jesus said, I'll be there at a marriage. You ever looked at Saul? He said, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall not want. Amen.
Amen.
Out here, we want some things sometimes. But over there, we ain't gonna have a want.
Thank you.
Amen. When we reach the other side, all of our wants and all of our desires is just going to completely disappear. And we'll be forever satisfied. See, Jesus done went a long ways before us. He said in John chapter number 14, he said, I go away to prepare for you. And if I go away to prepare for you a place, I'm coming in. That where I am, there you can be also. The only thing we got to do is wait on him. Just wait on him.
Yeah.
I don't know when he's coming. I can't give you a year like some of these great scholars. I can't even pick out a month in the year like some of these great theologians. But I know that he's coming.
Amen.
Amen. Until he comes, I think I'll just wait. Amen. Amen. I think I'll just wait. Amen. Just keep on doing what I'm doing. Amen. Trusting in him. Standing in the faith of his word. Amen. Standing on the promises. Amen. That'll never fail you. And I'll never let you down. Amen. Leaning on the light that'll guide you in the right direction. Amen. Amen. Boy, I'm telling you what, I believe these far akin to a calf. Amen. She could get up and walk through all the night. Amen. I never turned a light on. I got up the other night about 2:30. I said, I ain't going to wake her up. First thing I done is I stuck my big toe on the bedpost. Amen. Amen. Tonight I was a hollering woman, jumping around in the bedroom, holding my foot, trying not to scream. Amen. And boy, from that, I stumbled and my knee hit one of the drawers and was hanging out on the dresser. I'm going to kill myself before I get out of this bedroom. Amen. And she going to wake up. I'd be laying in the corner weeping today. Listen tonight, but I'm glad tonight in this old dark and gloomy world, amen, that there's one going before me tonight that's got the brightest light I've ever seen in my life. And he said, I'm going to share the light with you. I'm going to put the light in you. I'm going to lead you and guide you and help you get home and to be saved forevermore. So I say tonight, stand in the faith of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Come on back and get a song. Amen. Standing in the faith. Until you learn how to stand, you ain't never going to be able to walk. You ever notice a little baby? A little baby, before they'll ever take a step, amen, the first thing they learn to do is they'll get a hold of the table and they'll pull themselves up. And they'll just stand there. Amen. Like that's the biggest miracle that ever happened.
Amen.
Hey, these toes, I've been a wiggling all this time. And these legs, I've been a shake. They hold me up. Amen. And boy, I can imagine that's what's going through their mind. Amen. And boy, they'll look at you like, man, I have really accomplished something. Amen. I am here.
Yep.
Amen. Boy, look at me. I'm standing up. Amen. And brother, I'm telling you, that's what God does to us. Amen. We come down a weak old beggarly sinner, run by the things of this old world, all kind of ungodliness in our life, and he cleans us up. And when he cleans us up, he stands us up. Amen. Tonight, and boy, we stand there. We look around at the world with all different things in our eye. We look at what God has created. We thank him for everything that he's done and the joy that fills in our heart. Amen. Tonight, and the blessings that come down out of heaven, and our heart is overwhelmed and it's full of joy. Amen. And God puts a light in there. And then, honey, we learn how to walk and be obedient to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It don't come overnight. This next class that we're in, matter of fact, is learning to walk. There's still a lot of old people still dreaming. Man, hopefully this class will learn us to be a little bit more steadfast. Amen. I remember my grandson, whenever he'd hold on to the table, he'd be looking at me. Amen. Then me and Eve would say, hey, come to us. Amen. He'd take a couple steps and flop. Amen. Boy, he'd sit there and he'd look around, what happened, you know? And then he'd pull himself back up and he'd take a couple steps and flop. Amen. But boy, he got to where he was pretty steady. Amen. And the more we trust in him, and the more we stand in faith, and the more we wait upon God, the stronger we are in the Lord. Amen. Tonight, listen tonight, brother, I'm telling you, faith plays a very important part in your life. Amen. Tonight, listen, people, I will say this out of the goodness of my heart. When people get sick and they have a hard time, you know what they do? They go to the doctor.
Amen.
Might I say tonight, if we get burdened down with the things of this old world, and we get to going through trials that we don't understand, why don't we come to the physician? If we use the physician as much as we use the natural doctors, man, we'd be packs of dynamite. That's what God wants us to do. Standing in the faith. I hope and pray you've enjoyed this time. Let's all sing.
Page
81. Page 81. Let's all stand tonight. Amen. If you're here tonight, you will pray. Amen. The altar's always open. Amen. Tonight, and boy, what a good place it is. Just fall on our face. Cry out to the Lord. One more verse tonight, then we're going to close out. Lord, won't you just like y'all? At night I come to the Lord, man, I was broken in all pieces. Oh, the Lord sure put it back together. As we know how, Father, we come to you, God, thanking you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, for being so good to us tonight, God. And Father, we thank you, Lord, Father, for what our hearts has felt here tonight. And Lord, we pray tonight, God, that this message, Lord, would be an uplift, Lord, to thy people. And God, this morning, Lord, and Father, whenever troubles and trials come our way, Lord, just help us, God, to wait up on the mighty hand of God. Lord, to work these things out. God, we thank you tonight, Lord, for your saving, Father, grace that has saved us all. Lord, set us our feet up on a solid rock, planted us on the highway that leads from here to glory. Lord, there are a lot of rough spots in the road. There are a lot of battles. But God, we're glad tonight, Lord, that you said you'd never leave us or forsake us. But Lord, you'd go all the way even to the end of the world. God, how we thank you, Lord, for that precious and that holy promise. God, we pray, Father, you touch the hearts of men and women, Lord, that was gathered around this altar. Lord, some that are sitting there at the seat, God, Father, might have a need in their life. And Lord, we pray tonight, God, that through your grace and through your mercy, Lord, and through your strength, God, that you'd help each and every one tonight. Lord, how we love you. God, how we praise you, Lord, for everything, Lord, that you do. And God, we pray tonight, Father, to help us, Lord, to always give all the honor and the glory and the praise to this one called Jesus, the great I Am, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the Captain of our salvation. God, how we thank you tonight, Lord, for loving us. Father, touch these prayer requests tonight. Be with them, Lord, that are in the hospitals, God. Father, be with the ones, Lord, that wasn't able to be here tonight, God, for whatever reason. Lord, just be with them and touch them, Lord, in a mighty, mighty way. God, have your way in everything, Lord, that is said and done. And Father, whatever's accomplished, Lord, will not fail. God, to bow our head to give you all the praise and all the honor and all the glory. Father, for we ask these things in the mighty name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And amen and amen tonight. God bless tonight.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.